Welcome to a lesson on the period of a tangent and cotangent functions. The goals of the video are to determine the period of a function and also to graph the tangent and cotangent functions with various periods. So as mentioned earlier, a function f is said to be periodic if f of x is equal to f of x plus n times p. So if these two functions are equal for all values of x, the least possible constant p is called the period. And this period does have to be positive. A function with period p will repeat on intervals of length p. So the function we see here, after 5 units, it repeats itself, and therefore the period of this function is equal to 5. First of all, this video does assume that you're comfortable with the graphs of the basic tangent and cotangent functions. And as we see here, for y equals tan x, after negative pi over 2 to pi over 2, the function repeats itself, and therefore the period of this function is pi radians. And notice it's the same for a cotangent. After 0 to pi radians, the function begins to repeat itself. So the graph of y equals tangent bx or y equals cotangent bx will have the period of pi radians divided by b, or if we're talking about degrees, 180 degrees divided by b. So if we want to determine the period of y equals tan 3x, we have a value of b equal to 3. So the period will be pi divided by b, or 3. Therefore, the period is pi over 3 radians, which is equal to 60 degrees, or 180 degrees divided by 3. So in radians, it's pi over 3, and in degrees, it's 60 degrees. For y equals cotangent x divided by 4, you can think of this as 1x divided by 4. So the value of b is 1/4. So in radians, it would be pi divided by 1/4, which is pi times the reciprocal, or pi times 4, or 4 pi. And then again, in degrees, 4 pi radians is equal to 720 degrees. So again, we have the period in both radians and degrees. The amplitude of a periodic function measures its height. The amplitude is defined as the farthest distance the wave reaches from the center of the wave. However, since tangent and cotangent don't have maximums or minimums because they continue up forever and down forever, there is no amplitude. So here's the form of the equation we're graphing right now. B affects the period, and even though tangent doesn't have an amplitude, the value of A will affect the graph slightly, which we'll discuss shortly. Let's start off by finding the period. So remember, it's pi divided by b. In this case, our b is equal to 1/2. Well, pi divided by 1/2 is the same as pi times the reciprocal, or pi times 2, and that would give us 2 pi radians for the period. The basic tangent function can be graphed between negative pi over 2 and pi over 2 radians, but since the period is now 2 pi, we'll extend left as far as negative pi radians and as far right as pi radians. And within this interval, we can graph one complete piece of y equals 2 tan of x divided by 2. So we'll have vertical asymptotes at negative pi and pi radians now. Now, just as graphing the other trigonometric functions, we're going to divide this interval into 4 equal parts. And now graph key values of the function. So first thing we notice is that tangent of 0 radians is equal to 0. And the same will be true for this function. So we can graph. Notice on this fourth of the graph, the basic tangent function is equal to 1. And the corresponding point on this graph will be equal to 2, because wherever the tangent function is equal to 1, we're going to multiply it by 2. And on the fourth, where this function is equal to negative 1, this function will be equal to negative 2. And that's really enough information to make a decent graph of this function. We know the shape will stay pretty much the same, so it's going to approach this vertical asymptote on the right, and the same on the left. And of course, we could continue this pattern on intervals of 2 pi if we needed to. So notice that this value of A doesn't affect the amplitude, but it does kind of vertically stretch the basic tangent function on this new period. Let's go ahead and take a look at one more. We have an a value of 1/2, which again is not the amplitude for this function. This function does not have an amplitude. Our b value is equal to 2, so our period will be pi divided by 2 radians. We normally graph one complete piece of the cotangent function from 0 to pi radians, but now since the period is pi radians, we'll have a complete piece of the graph from 0 to pi over 2 radians. So we'll have a vertical asymptote at 0 and pi over 2 radians. Next, we'll divide this into 4 equal parts. Half of pi over 2 would be pi over 4. Half of that would be pi over 8. And so this would be 3 pi over 8. Now let's go ahead and graph some key points on this function. Looking at the graph of y equals cotangent x, notice on the interval equal to the period, at the halfway mark, this function is equal to 0. And it will stay the same on this graph. So at pi over 4, this function is equal to 0. Now in the first fourth, where this function is equal to 1, this function will be equal to 1/2, since it's 1/2 times the cotangent of 2x. And on the third fourth, where this function is equal to negative 1, this function will be equal to negative 1/2. And the general shape will remain the same, so our function will look something like this. And now we could repeat this if needed on intervals of pi over 2. What I'd like to do now is go back and take a look at both of these on the graphing calculator. Let's start by taking a look at this one. Now I'm in radian mode. Let's go ahead and take a look at the window first. Given the period was 2 pi radians, but we knew we'd have one complete piece of the function from negative pi to pi, I entered an x min of negative pi, an x max of pi, and I scaled the y-axis from negative 5 to 5. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to make the graph of the function we're trying to sketch bold. So I'm going to go to the left and press enter, and then we'll graph it. There's a graph of the basic tangent function, and there's a graph of y equals 2 tan x divided by 2. And notice that it's changed the period and also vertically stretched it slightly. Let's go ahead and take a look at our second example. So we'll graph the parent function first, y equals cotangent x. Remember that's going to be 1 divided by tan x, because they're reciprocals. Next, I'm going to graph 1/2 times 1 over tangent 2x. So I'll have 1/2 in parentheses times 1 divided by tan of 2x. And let's graph them. Again, the original function is thin, and the function we want to graph is in bold. Notice the period has obviously changed because it's only pi over 2 radians now, and it has been somewhat vertically compressed, even though it's hard to tell because the period has changed. Okay, that verifies our work. Hope you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching.